Champ Antonio Tyree, man. How you feeling today?
Feeling good, man. Feeling good.
Talk to us a little bit about what got us out here in Tampa.
Man, Bare Knuckle Fighting Championship 6. And we're here in Tampa, which was amazing to me, man. I didn't think we would get to Florida so soon. But that just goes to show you how fast this comeback sport is growing. I think they found a lane, you know what I mean? When you look back at how MMA has grown to the mega sport that it is today, you can see that Bare Knuckle has a lane and they could possibly grow as well. I think this is the fastest comeback sport that's growing right now, the fastest growing comeback sport, and they're building fans every fight. You see more and more people coming out. So the interest is definitely there.
We're on a commentating team, right?
Yeah, yeah, we're commentating.
How
Bare Knuckle.
I know it's different from being actually in the ring. How is it?
It's good, man. I mean, I'm learning these guys for the first time. You know, I'm very familiar with all of the fighters that are out there boxing professionally. But I have to educate myself on these guys' background story, you know, where they come from, and, you know, how they were, what up, man? How they was able to get involved in the game. So, yeah, Bare Knuckle coming on strong, man. And
as a fighter yourself, what's the difference from boxing and the Bare Knuckle? What do you think is the main difference?
I think Bare Knuckle, you have to be more technical. More technical in this thing. You just can't throw your hands comfortably like you would if they were protected with gloves on. So you might see a shot, but if it's on the top of the head or somewhere on a bone, you'll be advised not to throw that punch. So you're really gonna have to be technically sound to the point where you can pretty much place your shots. You just can't throw caution to the wind, because you can easily break your hand. And if you hurt your hand and Bare Knuckle, you're out of business. So you have to be conscious of that. So I think that's the difference.
Let's switch over to the sport that you used to run, boxing.
Yeah, 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 the sweet science, baby.
I know you just mentioned your son, Antonio Tarver Jr. Yeah. He fought Thomas Hill a couple of months ago. I actually bet on him and won.
Right, good man, good money, man, good money.
So talk to us a little bit about how you steering his career and what do you tell him as a young fighter?
Man, I'm going to tell you right now, from what I see today, the biggest regret I got that I didn't let him go when he was younger. But every time I brought him to the gym, I had to beat him off the bags. So that should have told me then it was in him. But I didn't want to be that type of parent that forced your child to, you know, or you live vicariously through your child's footsteps. No, I wanted him to decide what he wanted to do with his life. When he became an adult, he fell in love with the game. And I saw that he had the determination and the work ethic. So I'm just happy to be in his corner and be by his side training him and making sure that, you know, he gets what he wants out of the game of boxing.
Boxing and being heating up a little bit with the welterweights and the heavyweights. Did you catch the big heavyweight fight earlier this month with Joshua and Ruiz?
Oh man, I did. It was a great upset. I really liked what I saw in Ruiz, and I really was concerned about what I saw in Joshua. A lot of people want to blame his trainer, but it goes deeper than his trainer. What about his manager? What about his promoter? I think the whole team failed Anthony Joshua because they put that man in there knowing that he was less than 100%. They did him a disservice, but he got a second chance to get it right. I think he needs someone in there that can really work on his technical ability, game planning, and really breaking down the strategy and the style that he's gonna need to beat Ruiz. I think I'm that guy. I think my communication skills and being able to relate, to be able to have these guys relate to me, is a plus. You know what I mean? Because I've done it on all levels, man. And I think when you've spent 22 years in the game and you get out the game with all your faculties, never been cut, never been knocked out in your career, I think you know something. I think you have something. And I want to share that with the world. So all you top-notch fighters out there, all you prospects and contenders, even champions, if you feel you need a change, make that change. You know what I mean? Because you have to invest in your own career. And I think everyone needs a knowledgeable trainer that knows the ropes through experiences. Through experience. I walked it. I did it. I think I know a little bit about this game. They pay me to know what I'm talking about. So let me help you. Let me help you.
Do you think fighting in the Madison Square Garden in the first fight being in America was a little bit?
You know, coming to America is going to be a different for all those guys in the UK. But that was something more. It was something more than that. It was lack of preparation, lack of focus. It was a lack of everything. And a world champion, unified heavyweight champion, shouldn't be lacking in anything when it comes to preparation.
Another big fight that's brewing next month, Saints Pete Tarvin, Keith Thurman fight.
Oh, man, I'll be there in Las Vegas. In the ring with Tarvin Jones, will be there. We'll be on press row, and I can't wait to see that fight, man. You know what? Keith Thurman has been getting touched a little bit lately, more so than he ever has. Pacquiao, you know, is an aging fighter, but he still seemed to have his resolve and his ability and talent. Man, that's going to be a tough call. You want to go with youthfulness? You want to go with youthfulness in this fight? Because, you know, Keith Thurman is younger by a lot of years, a few years. But you can't count the old man out. You can't count the old man out, man.
Do you got a top five or pound for pound, or even if it's not pound for pound, what fighters do you like watching this today?
Well, I like a lot of the young fighters out there today. You know, Giovanni Davis is one of my top-notch fighters out there. I think he has a world of ability and skill and talent. Of course, Errol Spence, Crawford. You know, I like some of the UK fighters also. I think AJ has a chance to redeem himself if he get the right teacher. And, you know, a lot of guys out there, man, looking good. So I just want boxing to continue to thrive. I'll always be a part of that sport one way or another. And just to have my son coming up in the game, man, it just, God can't bless you no more than that.
Now, you just mentioned two technical fighters, Spence and Crawford. They meet down the line, man. Who do you have speaking that one out?
That's going to be a super fight. It's going to be a super fight. I think when you look at that fight, you got to look at that fight sort of like a Tommy Hearns and Sugar Ray Leonard. You know, I think they're gonna get the people's attention like that. They're going to captivate the people's attention. And I think that fight going to live up to the bill. I can't call a winner right now. I don't know who has the edge. That's a pick 'em fight. Both of these guys are in their prime. Both of these guys are coming into their own. And both of them are right now on legendary paths to be Hall of Famers. So, you know, they both got a lot to lose. I don't think anybody loses in that fight. I think the fans win in that fight, no matter when it takes place.
And for the ones that don't follow you, where can I keep up with you on social media?
Most definitely, at Antonio Tarver on all social medias. I have some beautiful merchandise, and you can keep up with me with my newsletter on my website at officialantoniotarver.com. And follow Junior as well, at Antonio Tarver Jr. on all social media platforms.
Man, the Creed series haven't tabbed you. I know you was in the Balboa series.
Man, can you believe that? No, we trying, man. We want to really revive Mason and Lion Dixon. I think he'll be a great opponent for Creed. You know, and if I can't get it done, then Junior can come up and get it done. So we already into that, man. We trying to revive Mason and Lion Dixon. So any of you Creed lovers out there, get the word out. Mason the Lion Dixon versus Creed. Who you got? Who you got?